Hello guys, welcome back to my channel, It Can Be Your Adventures, and this time we're on for another vlog, and it's very special because I'm gonna talk about my experience migrating in the United Kingdom and what I think is the difference between the laws, the work environment, and my experiences here in the United Kingdom as to my home country, which is the Philippines. Before we start the vlog for this time, I'm inviting everyone, for those of you who hasn't subscribed yet to my channel, It Can Be Your Adventures, please click the subscribe button and also hit the call bell for further notification in order for you to be updated with my life here in the United Kingdom as well as my adventures anywhere else in the world. And I wanted to extend also my heartfelt gratitude to you guys who have already got on board. And because we've already made a community of dreamers and we're continuously growing, we're now 1,333 subscribers in my channel, and I thank you guys for all your support and love. You are the best. This vlog is actually, I made it as a formal vlog. So guys, this vlog is a request of one of my classmates back in university when I was still studying nursing in the Philippines. His name is Gwyneth Valliar, so shout out to you. Thank you so much for dragging me into this requirement that you need for your master's in business administration. Thank you so much for thinking about me and in order for me to like impart and share about my experiences being a migrant worker in United Kingdom and my experiences here and how it is different from the Philippines where I used to live. So he's given me some set of questions in here. Actually, it's only like 6 questions, which is gonna be beneficial to all of you who are already here in the United Kingdom or who are planning to start or pursue a career abroad. Not specifically in the United Kingdom, but it can be anywhere else in the world. And because leaving your home country, working abroad is a big leap to do. It takes a lot of guts, a lot of decision making, as well as a lot of confidence and a lot of efforts and sacrifices in order for you to really get to where you are right now and also to live the life that you wanted. So living life in abroad is never easy. It's a roller coaster ride. There will be your ups and downs. But overall, if this is your dream in the first place, it will be truly worth it. When you get to experience the differences as well as if there are any similarities from the country where you used to grow up. So now for all of you guys who has not known me yet, my name is Kenneth. I'm 32 years old and I currently live in London, United Kingdom. I've arrived in London in the year 2015, February, winter time, very cold. And I was granted my permanent residency status last February 2020. So I'm now currently a permanent resident of United Kingdom. And hopefully by next year, February, I will earn my British citizenship. So I'm currently working as a nurse in a private hospital in London, United Kingdom. And I've been working here as a nurse for at least around 5 years now. And as a migrant worker, I will share to you my experiences based on the guide questions that Gwyneth has given me. So let's start. So his first question here is, what are your personal reasons why you migrated? There are a lot of reasons why I actually planned migrating abroad to augment our state as a family, you know, our financial status. We all know of that in the Philippines, working towards your dream or building a status that you don't need to like worry about what to eat tomorrow or what to spend for the next day is very challenging. And second one as well is also to flourish my career as a nurse here abroad. here in the United Kingdom, I was given a whole range of opportunity, not only to become as a nurse, but also to be a person. I was able to like develop my passion in different aspects, not only as a nurse, but also as a photographer, as a painter, as a consultant for research, as well as a lot of other things that is outside my profession, which is being a nurse. So second question is, what are the processes and challenges in order for you to come here to where you are right now or in United Kingdom? So let's start with the processes. So with the processes, you actually need first to finish your degree, earn a license in the Philippines. I did gain work experience, the necessary work experience in the Philippines, at least like 3 years in order for me to be qualified to work in the United Kingdom. And I found an agency or a manpower agency that hires nurses to be deployed in the United Kingdom. So that is one of the processes that you need to like really do, is to earn a degree, get experience, find an agency that will help or support you in order to be deployed in the country of your choice. The second one is, what are some of the challenges that I have to encounter in order to go here? I would say the process, because it's not that easy. There will be a lot of things that you need to comply in terms of documents, in terms of qualifications as well. Because the thing is, here in the United Kingdom, educational system in the Philippines is way too different than the educational system here in the United Kingdom. So they need to like verify everything. And then when you come here, you're not gonna be automatically working as a nurse, but as a nursing assistant. Because you need to do some training, they need you to send to a university, you need to take some computer-based exam for them to assess your capability as well as your competency as a nurse or a healthcare worker when you're gonna go here in United Kingdom. So I think that's one of the challenges that I would say I have to hurdle. So the fourth question is, what are some of the adjustments or any problems in your working environment, labor laws and all? Of that, I come from an Asian country. Asian culture is way too different from the culture here in Europe. You need to assimilate, or you need to integrate yourself with the culture of the British people. And also in here, you work with different types of people. So it's very, very important that you have to be very sensitive on how you speak, on how you move, or how you interact with them, so that you won't be misinterpreted. Apart from that, one of the best things that I would say working here as a migrant worker in United Kingdom is that you are valued. Every worker in the workplace are valued and are given equal opportunities. That I would say, which I think is way too different when you are in the Philippines, because in the Philippines, you would always feel the hierarchy in the Philippines. But in here, we work close hand in hand with the doctors, with the healthcare workers, with other allied healthcare workers in order to bring out the best with our patients. We are really protected here in terms of how we do things. We follow certain protocols, we follow certain guidelines in terms of how we work in the hospital. We have different procedures that we need to follow, as well as, you know, we pay taxes. And we also feel the tax that we pay to the government, because we gain so much benefits in terms of healthcare per se in here is free for everyone. And that is one of the best things that I would say I'm really thankful for as a migrant worker, because in the Philippines, healthcare is not free to everyone. Healthcare access is not available to everyone. But in here, everyone is given the opportunity and access to healthcare. We have our own problems as well in the hospital. We have our own problems in healthcare as well. We encounter crisis. But the thing is, at least the government is making sure that the taxes that we pay is given back to us in terms of healthcare, in terms of education, in terms of equal opportunities for work or labor. So the next question is, compare the difference between Philippines and here when it comes to benefits. So this is a bit broad, so probably I'd say in here, as I said earlier, we have free healthcare for all. So we don't pay anything to the government in order for us to have an operation, even if it costs money to send you to have this operation. Here in the UK, it's all free. For as long as you need it, they will do the best that they can to give you or to operate you or to do whatever it is, regardless of the status that you have, even if you don't have the money, you have equal opportunity for you for healthcare in here in abroad. Also, we pay taxes. So the taxes that we pay will be based on the work that we do, based on your profession. And also, we feel our taxes because it comes back to us, and we feel it because we were able to like benefit from it. Like, take for example, free healthcare, free education for our kids, as well as making sure that everyone is safe living here in the United Kingdom. So those things make so much of a difference. Whereas in the Philippines, it's way too different because the thing is, apart from you need to pay for your insurance, which we call the PhilHealth, which is a government insurance for healthcare, it's not even enough to cover all the costs incurred for you when you are hospitalized. So that's one thing that I would probably hope in the future that the Philippines would look into. So the next question is, how can you become a permanent resident and what are the benefits of a permanent resident here in the United Kingdom? So I've made a vlog about this one. If you haven't, for more information about this, visit my channel, It Can Be Your Adventures. Scan through all the vlogs that I have and you will see the process that you need in order for you to become a permanent resident here in the United Kingdom. But just to give you an overview, the very important thing in order for you to become a permanent resident here in the UK is for you to have a sponsored visa. At the first instance, someone has to sponsor you. You have to be on a working permit for at least like 5 years, continuous 5 years, and then you can apply for a permanent residency status. And what are your benefits? Now, your benefits, I would say, is one, you are entitled for free healthcare in the United Kingdom. You are also entitled for education, somehow free also from elementary into high school. And even somehow in college, the government will also support you finishing your university course. As well as you have also access to public funds as well. And you can also vote. You are a permanent resident here in the United Kingdom. So last question, what's your plan in the future? Is it to go home or to stay here permanently? I love United Kingdom. I also love Philippines because they say there's no place like home. And so Philippines will always be home for me. But because, you know, I already gained my residency status here in the United Kingdom, I wanted to like live longer here for many years. And probably when I grow old, maybe at my retirement years, I would probably go back to the Philippines because it's way too different in the Philippines. In the Philippines, you can be whatever you want. You don't have to worry about the future when you are already old because you can play the comfort of your home. You can always do the things that you wanted to do. You can always interact with your neighbors, with the people that you love. Unlike here, people are so workaholic. Majority of the people ended up in the nursing homes. And most of the money that they work for when they were still young all goes to them when they go to the nursing home. And I don't want to go to the nursing home. And I still love Philippines. In the long run, I will really go back when time comes that, you know, I'm already on my retirement years, probably 60 years old, 60 to 70 years old, I will go back to the Philippines and I will settle there for good. So guys, that's it. Thank you so much for listening to my experience as a migrant worker of United Kingdom. I hope that you get some inputs from me that you can apply to yourself, as well as to give you an idea of how you can start off a career or a life living outside the Philippines. And if you like this vlog, don't forget to drop your comments below and I'll be happy to hear your experiences as well. If ever you're already a migrant worker working away from the Philippines, as well as also comment down below to ask some questions or clarifications if you have any, and I'll be happy to answer your questions. And I think that's it really. Thank you so much, and once again, this is Kenneth, and thank you for being in my channel.